class we have learned about Turkish invasion, okay, and establishment of Delhi Sultanate. In Delhi, establishment of Delhi Sultanate, we have learned about the first the Sultan dynasty. It is Mamluk dynasty we have seen. Okay, in Mamluk dynasty we have seen the important rulers of Mamluk dynasty like Kutbuddin Aybak, Iltutmish, Razia Sultana. Okay, then last the Mamluk dynasty ends with Ghiyasuddin Balban. Okay, so we have seen the administration of Balban and everything. Okay, and in this class we are going to see how the Delhi Sultanate is expanded. Okay, and what was the rule of, what was the part of Khalji dynasty and Tughlaq dynasty in expansion of Delhi Sultanate? And we are going to see few of the important rulers of Khalji and Tughlaq dynasties. Okay, and when we see Tughlaq dynasty came to an end by 1209 CE. Okay, and after that, after the declination of the Mamluk dynasty, the Khalji dynasty came into being. The first ruler of Khalji dynasty was Jalaluddin Khalji. He became the ruler in 1290, and till 1296 he ruled in India. Okay, and he conquered most of the part of India. He was not the ambitious ruler. He was a pious ruler. Okay, he supported and he forgave the nobles and the other rebellious people who rebelled against him. Okay, and by using this generosity of Jalaluddin Khalji, Alauddin Khalji killed Jalaluddin Khalji and came into his power. Okay, so Alauddin Khalji became the ruler in 1296 to 1316 CE. Okay, and as soon as he became the ruler, the main motive of Alauddin Khalji was to expand his kingdom, to have the huge army, standing army, and in order to expand his kingdom, he also had different conquests. He invaded different parts of India. Okay, and what are the conquests he made, or what was the invasions he followed? Okay, when we see the conquests, he conquered Gujarat, Rajasthan region. Okay, he consolidated Gujarat and Rajasthan region. When we talk about Rajasthan, Rajasthan is consisted of, or it was ruled by different Rajput rulers. Okay, so what Alauddin Khalji did, Alauddin conquered Gujarat and Rajasthan. In Rajasthan he conquered different forts like Malwar, Bewar, okay, Mewar, okay, Malwar, Chittur, Randampur. Okay, these are some of the forts, important forts found in Rajasthan. These all the forts were destructed and demolished, and the Rajput rulers there became submission to him. Okay, and here the important incident that took place was Jaugar. Now what is Jaugar? Jaugar is the compulsory or voluntary suicide which is done by the Rajput woman in Rajasthan. Okay, because of this, Alauddin killed and made the Rajput rulers. Okay, this Rajput women don't want to fall into the hands of the Muslim rulers. Okay, they wanted to keep their purity, so they attempt Jaugar. Okay, it is the mass suicide. Jaugar is a mass suicide attempt by the Rajput women in Rajasthan during the period of Alauddin Khalji. Even it happened in the later period also. And when we see Alauddin Khalji, by 1305 he became the master of the North India. The whole of North India was conquered by Alauddin Khalji. And he, after conquering the North India till Rajasthan and Gujarat, he concentrated on Deccan region. So Alauddin Khalji was the first Turkish ruler who invaded till Deccan. And we can see later had taken back policies. What are the important policies he had? And what was the reason for invading Deccan? Okay, Deccan consisted of different temple cities. His main motive was to plunder the temple cities and take the wealth and use it for maintaining the huge army. Now we'll see what is the Deccan policy.
Of the
huge army. He in maintaining army, he followed two important system. One is dog and other one is chera. Okay, what is dog? D-A-G-H, dog. Okay, dog means branding of horses. Okay, he had the horse force also. So he branded the high quality horses from Saudi Arabia. Okay, and another system is called chera. Chera is the descriptive role of the soldiers. Okay, so the soldiers were divided their duties, and their duty was given, the respective duty was given to each soldier. Okay, not only that, he also had different officers to watch over the duties of this the soldiers. The spy system was allotted. Okay, so the information which he got from the spies were reflected through the punishments. There were severe punishments given by Alauddin Khilji to the people, those who disobey his rules. And when we see the next thing is revenue reformation. Okay, what was the revenue system adopted by Alauddin Khilji? Now his main motive was to increase the standing army. Okay, so to maintain the standing army, he needs lot of money. What he did in part of revenue system, he divided or he measured the land. Okay, Alauddin Khilji measured the land, and based on the measurement of the land, the tax was collected. Okay, there was a fixed tax for everything. Okay, that he increased the tax from the people. Okay, and also he did not bother about the income which the people yielded from the land, but the particular income was gained by Alauddin Khilji from the people. Land revenue was severely followed by Alauddin Khilji. And the next thing is market policy. As part of the market policy, he also had divided the market into three classes. Okay, in the first set, when we see, first market was kept for food grains. Second thing is for costly items, and the third cloth and costly item, and the third market fixed for the slaves, horses and cattle. Okay, so three set of market was there. Then for the constant checkup of market, there were different officers were appointed, and the officers, they watch over the functions of the market, and different weights and measures were used by the people in the market to avoid corruption and all the other things. This was the important policies which was followed by Alauddin Khilji. And when we see in 1305, most of the North India wars came under the control of Alauddin Khilji. Then Alauddin Khilji, after the Alauddin Khilji's died, Alauddin Khilji died in 1305 BC. After Alauddin Khilji, the rulers were not strong. Okay, so the Khilji dynasty went to the hands of Tughlaq dynasty. Okay, in Tughlaq dynasty, Jalaluddin Tughlaq was the Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq was the ruler, okay, of Tughlaq dynasty. He was also ambitious ruler. Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq also was ambitious ruler. He also a good army commander. Okay, he also established different policies to establish his kingdom in India. Then after Jalaluddin, who came into the power, it is Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Okay, now we will see the important three policies which is followed by Muhammad bin Tughlaq in his period. So after the Khilji dynasty came to an end, Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, he became the first ruler of Tughlaq dynasty. Okay, and after Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq, Muhammad bin Tughlaq came into power, and he ruled from 1215 to 1324. It was the period of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. During his period, he brought three important policies. Okay, Muhammad bin Tughlaq is often called a foolish Tughlaq. What's the reason to call Muhammad bin Tughlaq important policies, okay, that became full, okay, that affected his entire kingdom in India. The first one is taxation of Dhoba, okay. And the next thing is transfer of capital. And the next thing is foreign policy. Okay, there are three important foolish attitudes that were followed by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. The first one is taxation in Dhoba. Now what happened? Dhoba is the fertile region, okay, and it comes under the northern plains. Okay, often what happens, there will be a constant flood that affect the crops and the people. It affect the life and property of the people. Now, taxation of Dhoba, when we talk about Muhammad bin Tughlaq, he collected the fixed tax from the region of Dhoba, even from the period of flood and scarcity of water. Okay, so the people, they suffered, they couldn't pay the tax, and people, those who paid, couldn't pay the tax also, they were punished by Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And because of this reason, people were against of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Okay, not only that, now taxation in Dhoba. Because of this thing, what happened? The Dhoba region became the region of minting coins. Okay, every house they mint coin. Okay, so the corruption and the duplicate coin which was prevailed during that period, which affect the rule of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. And the next thing is transfer of capital. He transferred the capital from Delhi to Devagiri. Okay, Delhi to Devagiri, we can say it as Aurangabad. Okay, so what happened because of this shifting of capital? He did not shift the capital, he along with the shifting of capital, he also shifted the people from one place to another. So during his transfer of capital, he forced the people to move, those who are living in Delhi to move to Devagiri, and from people to Devagiri to Delhi. This brought a lot of life damage, property damage to the people. Okay, and at last, when he became realized his mistake of transferring capital, he asked the people once again to come back into their old place. Okay, this affected the life of people. Not only it affected the life of the people, it also affected the administration of the government. Okay, so all the officials also had to forcefully to move from Delhi to Devagiri. That affected the people. And the next thing is foreign policy. One of his motive was to become the world leader. He wanted to conquer the whole world. So in order to conquer the whole world, he recruited different soldiers, and he paid the 1 year salary to the soldiers beforehand. Because of that, what happened? The treasury became empty. Okay, because of paying tax, paying salary for 1 year to the soldiers, the treasury became empty. There was no money to maintain his stand army or the government. That's why he is considered as the foolish Tughlaq. Then after the Muhammad bin Tughlaq period, his power came to an end by 1324. And after that, there were two important dynasties. They ruled India, that is Sayyid dynasty, and another one is Lodi dynasty. Okay, the Timur invasion was occurred in India, and the Kirgan became the viceroy. The Timurs, they appointed Kirgan as viceroy in part of to take control over India. Okay, and after that, after Kirgan, he left India, the power came into the hands of Sayyid. Okay, Sayyid dynasty. And after Sayyid dynasty, Lodi dynasty came to power. Okay, in Lodi dynasty, Muhammad Lodi was the famous ruler in Lodi dynasty. When we talk about this Khalji dynasty and Tughlaq dynasty, there were lot of comparison and contrast. Most of the administrative policies were followed same by the Khaljis and the Lodis. Okay, and what was the contrast? It is the foolish measures taken by Muhammad bin Tughlaq that abolished the Tughlaq dynasty, and that also became the reason for the end to Tughlaq dynasty. So, like that, in India, the expansion of Delhi Sultanate was done by five of the dynasties, that is Mamluk dynasty, Khalji dynasty, Tughlaq dynasty, Sayyid dynasty, and Lodi dynasty. And after the end of the Lodi dynasty, the Delhi Sultanate came into an end. Okay? Then after that, the Mughals started to rule India. Children, today we have learned about the expansion of Delhi Sultanate and the rulers of Khalji and the Tughlaq dynasties and how their administration, what are the efforts it brought into the Indian government in the Delhi Sultanate. Okay, children, so here we end the class. You read your lesson well. This is your topic for next week test. Prepare your portions well. We will meet in the next class. Thank you, children.